Hey guys, it's Matt Shue from Upright Health, and let's talk about a hidden cause of hip pain that is strangling the health of your hips right now. It's your pants. Your pants are messing with your hip mobility. So this is something that took me a while to figure out, but as my hips have gotten more mobile, it's become more clear that the choice of pants really messes with my hip mobility. So let's talk about this. When you wear pants that are too tight, either around the thighs or around the waist, it's going to change what you're able to do with your pelvis. So for example, if you have really tight thighs on your pants and you go to lift up like this, the pants actually constrict your ability to get hip flexion. If you can't get hip flexion, you get really crappy at hip flexion. You lose this ability, and that starts looking like things like FAI or hip impingement when you can't hip flex, right? You start going to your doctor and you say, I've gotten really bad at this. And your doctor says, well, that's because you have bad bone shapes. But it could be that you have actually trained poor hip mobility with your super tight thighs on your skinny jeans without any stretch. So that's issue number one, is loss of hip flexion. Also loss of hip extension. If the pants are too tight there, you may not be able to go all the way back. So now you've lost two ranges of motion, and you're not going to be surprised if I say, hey, if it's too tight around the seat, that when you try to go out to the side and abduct, you're not going to be able to do that either because the pants are restricting you. Another thing to think about is the actual place where the pants sit. So if they are like low rise versus high rise, if you have pants that are sitting really low here, down like around the middle butt or like below your butt, the top of your butt cheek, which is a lot of people's pants these days because it's the style. When you go to lift and you have these tight pants, you have these skinny jeans, it actually will create a pull point, meaning the waistband is going to be pulling on your butt cheeks and pulling you into posterior tilt. So instead of getting that hip flexion from the hip joint, you start to get posterior pelvic tilt to try to cheat to get your leg up. So I've noticed this with a lot of pants. There are a couple brands of pants that I've tried on where my butt is just too big for those pants. And when I go to lift, it just tilts me like that. That is, again, messing with my hip mobility. So things you need to think about when you are looking at pants and you're trying to improve your hip mobility overall is to make sure you have stretchy pants. So the pants I'm wearing right now, pretty stretchy. They have a lot of stretch material in them. I try now to buy pants only with stretch in them, or they have to be cut in a way where it does not interfere with my mobility. So in the dressing room, I'll often be just hanging out in the dressing room in pants, checking to make sure I can do this, checking to make sure I can do this and this, just whatever I need to be able to do in my pants. I don't want the pants to restrict me. So the dressing room needs to be big, or at least have room to squat. Anyway, the other thing to think about is with the style of pants available these days, a lot of them are really skinny around the thighs. A lot of them, especially if you're talking about jeans, will restrict you, and they will even cut off blood flow because they're so tight and so low rise. So we've actually noticed that people who have high rise pants, or that high rise pants in general, can help you be a little bit better with your hip mobility because you're not losing control and differentiation between your pelvis and your low back. When you have the waistband kind of low, right up against your ASIS, the anterior superior iliac, then it's gonna screw with how you feel your motions. You stop hip hinging so well, and then you start hinging at the spine. So making sure you are clear about how your pants affect you is gonna help you improve your hip mobility. If you have FAI or hip arthritis or whatever, make sure your pants aren't contributing. Now, what about in the winter? So I'm outside right now. You've probably just heard the airplanes flying overhead. I'm outside, it's cold. It's probably like 40, maybe low 50s right now. I'm bundled up. These pants that I'm wearing are not themselves that thick. But what you can do is make sure you get thermals that are good enough and flexible enough and that also don't restrict you. So what I've seen and experienced with some of these base layers is Some of them are too tight, so then they feel constrictive, and then they screw up my hip mobility. And then some of them don't interface well with the pants, so you have to try this out. I've had some pants that are totally fine on their own, and they move really well on their own, but when I then put on a base layer and I put those pants over, the base layer and the pants restrict each other, and then I end up with that hip flexion problem, abduction problems. So you just need to test this out. What works for me is using a thinner outer layer and then the thicker base layer. So I'll use like thermal weight base layers that are really flexible and mobile in order to make sure I can still move. So whatever you're doing, if you're trying to improve your hip mobility, remember to think about your pants. Think about how to ensure that your pants are not screwing you over so that you can move well, feel good, think right, move right, and feel right. I hope this helps you out. Whether you have FAI, hip arthritis, or whatever, labral tears, I don't care, whatever it's called, you can still fix it. If you need help training your body, training your hips, whatever it is, check out our website, uprighthealth.com/DIY. We'll show you all of our programs. If you want stuff focused directly on your hips, check out uprighthealth.com/hip help. Links will be in the description box below. I hope this helped you out. Click the like button, subscribe, and as always, remember that pain sucks, life shouldn't.